So in question, what is given? The wavelength of a probe is roughly a measure of size of a structure that it can probe in some detail. The quark structure of protons and neutrons appears at the minute scale, minute length scale of 10^-15 meter or less. Okay, or less, because we are measuring quark structure, and quarks are basically smaller than proton, and proton and neutrons are inside the nucleus, and size of nucleus is 10^-15 meter approximate, obviously. So size of quarks must be less. Okay, maximum it may be 10^-15, but most of the time it will be less. So this structure was first probed in early 1970s using high energy electron beams produced by a linear accelerator. So linear accelerator means we have some arrangement, like we can throw it, basically it is an electron gun. Okay, we can accelerate electron at very high speed, and we can make them travel in a line that is linear accelerator. Okay, at Stanford, USA. USA mein experiment hua tha. So guess what might have been the order of energy of these electrons. So the electron which are used in linear accelerator, okay, or electron gun. So what might have their energy in this question they are asking. And what is data given? Rest mass energy of electron is 0.511 mega electron volt. So basically we have to find out energy. So for energy, so what we can do here? So formula for energy is basically E is equal to mc square. This is very famous relation of Einstein, E is equal to mc square. And this formula we can use here, but we cannot use, because see, this is linear accelerator and electrons are moving with very high speed. So electron is a charged particle, and it is very smaller in size and moving with the speed which is comparable with the speed of light. So they have relativistic, or they have moving mass. Moving mass, you can not correct word, you can say this is rest mass basically. Okay, here m0, that is rest mass energy. Okay, but when it will move, jab electron ruka hua hai, so it has this much energy. But when it will start moving, so it have different energy. Okay, that is called relativistic energy of electron. Okay, so we know that when any particle move with very high speed, so their energy become different. Okay, so in that case we use momentum actually. Okay, we measure that energy with the help of momentum. Therefore in quantum mechanics or in modern physics, momentum is very important term to calculate energy. So basically, see, this is E is equal to mc square. Okay, so now what I'll do here, I can do, so E is equal to, so multiply it, this equation. Okay, so what you will get, E square, actually square it, so E square is equal to m square, and this becomes c^4. So what I can write here, E is equal to m square into c square. So this term become p square, momentum. Okay, this term become p square, let me shift it, p square and c square. This is the relativistic energy. Okay, actually there is a rest mass energy also, this is rest mass, but this is very less compared to this, because high accelerator they are using. Now you have to calculate this momentum. You know the speed of light, that is 3×10^8 meter per second. So you have to ignore this rest mass energy. Actually this is also included in the equation, but here it is very less, so we can ignore, it is negligible. So we can put this value and you can find out answer. So what is answer? Let's calculate momentum. So what is momentum basically? So in case of de Broglie wavelength, momentum is p is equal to h by lambda. And what is h? H is 6.63×10^-34 joule second divided by lambda. So lambda is basically 10^-15 meter. It is given here. Let me show you. This is what 10^-15 meter it is given. So 10^-15 put here. 10^-15. So what you will get basically? 6.63 into 10 raised to minus 34 and 15. So basically 34 and 10. So you will get minus 19, okay, kg meter per second. This is what momentum. Now put this value here. Here you have to put. So E square is equal to, so 6.63 into 10 raised to minus 19 whole square into 3 into 10 raised to 8, that is C square. So when you will solve it, so 6.63 into 10 raised to minus 38 into 3 into 3 into 10 raised to 16. So 16 and 38. So it will be 38 and 10. 28 and 622. So it is 6.63 into 6.63 into 10 raised to minus 22 into 3 into 3. This is what E square. So therefore E is equal to, you will get 6.63 into 3 into 10 raised to minus 11. Okay, this is in joule. This is your approximate energy of that electron which in linear accelerator. Okay, now for verification you can check here E is equal to m naught c square. What is it, this energy? This energy will come very less. So mass of electron, rest mass 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 9.1, actually it is E is equal to, okay. So actually it is given already, m naught c square 0.511 electron volts. So no need to do this. So you can, what you can do here, so this rest mass energy, basically m naught c square is equal to 0.511 into 10 raised to mega, means 10 raised to 6 into electron volt. So 1 electron volt, that is nothing but 10 raised to minus, you can see here, 10 raised to minus 19 joules. So when you will solve this, you will get 0.511 into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 13 joule. Okay, so you can see here, this is coming 6.63 into 3 into 10 raised to minus 11, and it is coming 10 raised to minus 13, 0.55, this one. Okay, so this is what your answer, that is 6.6 into 10 raised into 3 into 10 raised to minus 11 joule is your answer. Next question will go. So in next question, what they are asking? So next, in this question they are asking about, see, let me put it in the screen. Okay. Find the typical de Broglie wavelength associated with a helium atom in helium gas at room temperature 27 degrees Celsius and 1 atmospheric pressure, and compare it with the mean separation between 2 atoms under these conditions. So basically, you have to calculate typical de Broglie wavelength. So you know the formula, lambda is equal to h upon p. This is the formula for typical de Broglie wavelength. So we have this h, but we don't have this p. So how to find out momentum? So momentum you can find out. So this is helium atom, and in thermodynamic, while teaching 11th standard, I told you this is a diatomic gas, and in case of diatomic gas, its kinetic energy, that is half mv square, is given by 3 by 2 kt, where case the Boltzmann constant is the absolute temperature. Okay, so here what you can do, so you can write, we have to find out momentum, so we have to take care of this term, we can convert it into momentum. So this two will get cancelled, so what you will get, mv square is equal to 3 kt. So multiply by m, okay, so when you will multiply m by m, so you will get m square v square is equal to 3 m kt. This side you have to multiply, so this is what p square you will get. So p square is equal to 3m kt. So therefore p is equal to root 3m kt. Now you have to substitute this value of p here. So you will get de Broglie wavelength. So let's substitute. So lambda is equal to what? So lambda is equal to h upon root 3m kt. Now question is, we have h here, we have t here already given, k is a constant, 3 is also a number, m, how to find out this m, that is mass of helium atom. So basically we have helium gas, you can find out mass of helium atom. So basically formula for that, mass of helium atom is equal to atomic weight of helium divided by total number of helium atom, that is Avogadro number. Okay, so what you will get, so basically you will get atomic weight divided by 6 into 10 raised to 23, that is this Avogadro number. So what you will get here? So 4 divided by 6 into 10 raised to 23. Sorry, just a minute. 6 into 10 raised to 23. This will come in gram. So you can convert into kilogram. So this 4 into 10 raised to minus 3 divided by 6 into 10 raised to 23 and divide 23, so this will come in kg. Okay. So when you solve this, so you will get 4 to just 2 to 4, okay. So this will come 2 and this is 3, so this will give you 2 by 3 into 10 raised to minus 26 kg, this is mass. Okay, so now you have mass, so you have to put this value of mass where actually you have to put here this mass. Okay, so when you will solve this, you will get lambda is equal to 6.63 into 10 raised to minus 34. 10 raised to minus 34 divided by root 3 into mass is how much? 2 by 3. So this 3, this will get cancelled. So numerical become easy. Into 10 raised to minus 26 into K. So K is basically 1.38 into 10 raised to minus 23 into T. T is the temperature, it is given 27 degrees Celsius. See here, it is 27 degrees Celsius. So we have to take SI units. So Kelvin may convert karoge to, how much it will become? It will become 300. 27 degrees Celsius is equal to 300 Kelvin. So when you will solve it, you will get wavelength. So wavelength will come approximate 0.73 into 10 raised to minus 10 meter. So this is what your wavelength. Now what they are asking, and compared, so this wavelength, whatever we get 0.73 into 10 to minus 10 meter, this wavelength you have to compare with the mean separation between two atom under these conditions. So mean separation, see, in helium molecule, gas basically, there are n number of particle, okay, and distance between two particle is different from other two different particle. So in this case we take mean separation concept. So mean separation, how you can get? So you can, if you divide by this volume by total number of molecule, total number of atom, helium atom, okay, so you will get mean separation distance. Okay, so how to get this quantity? So by using ideal gas equation, PV is equal to nRT. Okay, PV is equal to RT, and is a number of moles, so it is 1 in case of, so PV is equal to RT. So from this, so we can write PV, okay,
AB equal to
K N T. What is this K?
So this K is basically R by N.
R by N. K is equal to. So K. So what you will get? K. Right. So N R K N T. Right. So now here we can say V by N is equal to P to niche aayega, okay, KT by P. This formula you have to use, okay, and for mean separation formula, actually R is equal to this molar volume upon Avogadro number, that is KT by P raised to 1/3. So this is the formula you have to use. You have all the values, K and T also given, and P is the atmospheric pressure, and you have to convert it into Pascal. So you know one atmospheric pressure is equal to 1.01 into 10 raised to 5 Pascal. Now by putting all this value, you have to solve this. So when you will solve this, so you will get mean separation. So you will get R is equal to, I'm writing here, R is equal to 1.38 into, that is K, to minus 23 into 300 divided by 1.01 into 10 raised to 5 and raised to 1/3. When you will solve this, so you will get basically 3.4 into 10 raised to minus 9. It will be 10 raised to minus 9 meter. So this is what you are getting R, and this is what you are getting wavelength. Now compare, one is coming in the range of 10 raised to minus 9, and one is coming 10 raised to minus 10. So it means R is greater than wavelength. Okay, so means separation between two helium atom and their wavelength, and wavelength emitted by helium atom, okay, so is less compared to separation between them. Okay, so it means what? And you know the wavelength is a property of color also. Okay, so you can distinguish, you can see distance or see two different helium atom. This is what actually they are asking. Okay, so I hope this doubt is clear, and thank you for watching.